Hello students, welcome to Marine Engineering Tutorials. I am Atul Kumar Gupta and back with a new tutorial. We are presently studying marine boilers. Today we have 10th lecture and the topic is atemperators and desuperheaters. Atemperators and desuperheaters are both used to reduce the degree of superheat, but their purposes are different in each case. Atemperators are used to control the final degree of superheat so that steam temperature does not exceed the design value, which can result in failure of superheater. Atemperators are installed between primary and secondary superheaters. On the other hand, desuperheaters are used to reduce the steam temperature so that the steam is close to saturated condition, which can be used for auxiliary purposes where superheated steam is not required. A question can come in mind: why saturated steam can't be taken directly from steam drum, and what is the need to superheat first and desuperheat it later? This practice is used to prevent damage to the superheater, especially at low load condition when requirement of superheated steam is small, such as ship maneuvering, etc. This practice ensures adequate flow of steam through superheaters and does not get overheated due to starvation of steam. This sketch shows an air-cooled atemperator used on Foster Wheeler ESD1 type boiler. Let us first see the components of the atemperator and the flow of combustion air and steam through it. We can see the fin tubes shown in each of the diagram. One is taken through the front, the section one, and another is from the side. Then we can see the supply damper for the combustion air. This is the bypass damper. When a temperature is not required, then the air can be bypassed. This is the bypass air flow passage. This is the air outlet to the burners. This is the combustion air from FD fan, when you see for the other sketch. And we have combustion air to the burners. From the bottom connection to this header, we have steam from primary superheater. And from the upper header, it leads to the secondary superheater. It consists of W-shaped finned coil arranged in the combustion air path between primary and secondary superheaters. To control the final temperature of the superheat, link dampers are used to control the supply of combustion air through a temperator or bypass it. This sketch shows an externally arranged water-cooled temperator. Let us first see the flow of steam and water through it. We can see that the water from the steam drum enters to the shell of the atemperator. Then from the other connection, it goes back to the steam drum, and the circulation is maintained by the temperature difference. In the header we can see the superheated steam enters from the top and the attenuated steam goes out to the secondary superheater. This attenuator is of shell and tube type, in which U tubes are attached to the header, which has steam inlet and outlet connections. Cylindrical shell has water inlet and outlet connections from steam drum. The incoming water gets heated by the steam passing through U tubes. Temperature difference at two ends causes the circulation of water through the steam drum. So this arrangement is used in some of the boilers. This sketch shows a integral surface type water cooled attenuator which is located in the steam drum. Let us see the components of the attenuator and flow of steam through it. We can see the box header to which the U-tubes are attached. Then at the bottom connection of the header, superheated steam enters and leaves from the upper end of the box header to the secondary superheater. U-tubes attached to header are submerged in the water, which give up their heat to the surrounding water. Supply of water steam to a temperature is through a three-way valve, which is used to automatically maintain the steam temperature through a controller. Water-cooled de-superheater is similar in construction to water-cooled temperature, but is located in the water drum. This sketch shows a spray type de-superheater in which the heat exchange between steam and water takes place by direct contact. This type of de-superheater is used where large amount of de-superheating is required. Let us see the components of the spray type de-superheater and the flow of steam, sprayed water and condensate. We can see a thermostat which senses the temperature of the de-superheated steam and is used to regulate the amount of flow entering into the superheated steam to cool it down. Then we have water control valve, which is regulated by the thermostat to control the amount of water spray. Then we have water spray nozzle through which the mist of the water enters into the and mixes with the superheated steam. Then we have a mixing tube outside which is surrounding the inner tube. Then we have inner mixing tube in which the superheated steam enters and the water is sprayed. Then we have a orifice plate. Before this, the superheated steam leaves, it passes through the orifice plate to ensure that any water droplet being carried with it is converted into steam. We have a water trap at the bottom of the inner tube which ensures that no water goes down and only the steam leaves the inner tube. Then we have a water level gauge glass to regulate the amount of water to see if water is not rising. Then we have a steam trap Any condensate at the bottom can drain out, but this will prevent the flow of steam to the drain. Then at the bottom we have a drain, and this is the superheated steam inlet which leads the steam to the inner tube. And finally we have a de-superheated steam outlet. Superheated steam enters through the inner mixing tube, in which water is sprayed through the nozzle, which absorbs the latent heat from superheated steam and is converted into steam. Water trap at the bottom of the inner tube allows only the steam to pass through, which flows up in the outer mixing tube and leaves through orifice plate, which ensures evaporation of any water droplets leaving with the steam. Any condensate formed drops down and is drained away by the steam trap located at the bottom. A thermostat at the steam outlet senses this temperature and controls the supply of water through water control valve. Spray type de-superheater is also used on conventional motor tankers while dumping the live steam during the starting of inert gas plant. And this completes our study of temperatures and de-superheaters. This book is written by me and covers all the topics as per Indian Maritime University syllabus. It clarifies the concepts with simple illustrations. This book also provides answers to all the questions which have appeared in the examination conducted by Indian Maritime University. This book can help the students in preparing for the exam and also to work on the ship's boiler safely. Hope that you have liked the lecture. You can write your feedback in the comment box. If you have liked the tutorial, you may share it with your friends. You may subscribe to the channel for getting notification about the new tutorials. I'll be back with a new lecture shortly. Thanks for watching till the end.